The major components of a typical human cell. The main components of a typical human cell include the plasma membrane, the cytoplasm, including the organelles and cytoskeleton, and the nucleus. The plasma membrane is the outer boundary of a cell. It is composed mainly of a double layer of phospholipid molecules that are held together by chemical attractions. These phospholipid molecules have a water-soluble head and lipid or fat-soluble tails, so they form a bilayer that acts like a fence, allowing lipid-solid molecules to pass through easily and preventing water-soluble molecules from passing through easily. The cytoskeleton is the internal framework of a cell, as it provides structural support and allows the movement of materials. The cytoskeleton is made up of fibers that form a kind of scaffolding, which are made up of protein molecules. There are three different types of fibers: microfilaments, intermediate filaments, and microtubules. Microfilaments are the smallest of the three, and they are made of twisted strands of proteins. They can be pulled together to shorten the cell, such as in muscle contraction. Intermediate filaments are also twisted strands of proteins that provide much of the framework support in a cell as they hold the cell together. Microtubules are made up of proteins that take on a spiral shape to form a hollow cylinder. They help maintain the cell shape and move some of the organelles within a cell. The centrosome is typically found near the nucleus, and it basically builds and breaks apart microtubules in the cell. It consists of centrioles that are perpendicular to each other, which have 9 bundles of microtubules with 3 tubules in each bundle. The cytoplasm consists of the cytosol, which is a watery solution also referred to as intracellular fluid. It has a syrup-like consistency and contains a high water content. The cytoplasm also houses the tiny organs or organelles in the cell. The first organelle that we're going to look at is the endoplasmic reticulum. There are 2 types of endoplasmic reticulum, the rough ER and smooth ER. The rough ER extends out from the nucleus and has ribosomes attached to its membrane, giving it a rough appearance. These ribosomes produce proteins or polypeptide chains, which are either embedded into the membrane of the ER or enter the lumen or cavity of the rough ER. Here they are modified, packaged, and stored until they are released. They are transported by enclosed membrane sacs called transport vesicles that pinch off from the smooth ER. These vesicles transport the proteins to another organelle called the Golgi apparatus for further modification. The smooth ER is a membranous organelle that does not have any ribosomes. The smooth ER contains enzymes that alter polypeptides, synthesize lipids and carbohydrates, and destroy toxins. Most of the phospholipids and cholesterol that form cell membranes are synthesized in the smooth ER. Ribosomes can be found attached to the rough ER or scattered freely throughout the cytoplasm. They are a non-membranous structure comprised of large and small subunits. Ribosomes are protein factories. The two subunits come together as transfer RNA brings amino acids to the ribosome, and messenger RNA provides the code of how to assemble the amino acids into a polypeptide chain. The Golgi apparatus is a membranous organelle that's main function is to modify, package, and store proteins. Transport vesicles delivering proteins from the ER fuse with the first cistern of the Golgi apparatus. Here they release the proteins, which are modified by enzymes. Modification of the molecules continues as it moves through the Golgi apparatus by way of the Golgi vesicles. Some of this modification may include the addition of carbohydrates to form glycoproteins. After modification is complete, they are pinched off in another vesicle called the secretory vesicle, where many are sent to the cell's plasma membrane. At the plasma membrane, some of the components of the vesicle are released outside of the cell, and some vesicles become part of the plasma membrane itself. Lysosomes are membranous vesicles that pinch off from the Golgi apparatus, and they contain digestive enzymes. Lysosomes are like garbage bags, picking up cellular waste or picking up defective organelles and recycling the contents. Lysosomal enzymes also help a cell destroy bacteria and viruses engulfed by the cell. Proteasomes are cylindrical protein-destroying organelles found throughout the cytoplasm. They are responsible for breaking down abnormal and misfolded proteins and normal proteins that are no longer needed by the cell. A targeted protein is marked by having a separate protein called ubiquitin bound to it. The ubiquitin pulls the protein into the proteasome where many of its peptide bonds are broken. The resulting smaller peptide chains and amino acids are then released to be recycled by the cell. Peroxisomes are membranous vesicles that are pinched off from the rough ER. Peroxisomes break down long-chain fatty acids and amino acids, and also contain the enzyme that decomposes the harmful hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen inside the cell. Mitochondria, which are found in the cytoplasm, are the power plants of cells, as they can take energy from food molecules and use it to build ATP molecules, ATP being the energy currency of cells needed to do cellular work. Mitochondria have an inner and outer membrane and vary in numbers depending on the amount of work a cell does. For instance, liver cells contain 1,000 or more mitochondria, and frequent aerobic exercise increases the number of mitochondria in skeletal muscle cells. The nucleus is the largest of all cell structures, and it has two membranes that form a nuclear envelope that, along with nuclear pores, enclose the nucleoplasm. The nuclear pores allow certain molecules into and out of the nucleus. And inside the nucleus is the nucleolus, which is comprised of protein and RNA. The nucleolus is responsible for producing the large and small subunits of ribosomes. The nucleus also contains DNA, and in non-dividing cells, appear as tiny bunches and are called chromatin. Some cells have extensions, such as microvilli, which are important in nutrient absorption, cilia, which push substances along the surface of a cell, and flagella, which help to propel an entire cell. We will cover these in depth in a later video. And that be the basics on the components of a typical human cell.